The first thing is that people who use the internet and the devices that are attached to it need to feel a certain amount of shared responsibility for the way in which they use these systems. For example, if they pick very bad passwords and other people figure them out and accounts are attacked, they may be harming third parties as a consequence if someone gets into your account and then takes advantage of that to get into something else. So we have a cascading potential. So we have user responsibility is there, and we have to help people understand what those responsibilities are. So we need educational institutions, we need the parliaments of the world and the legislators of the world to recognize that the public needs to be educated about the use of these technologies. So that's one point. The second thing is that we need to allow as much creativity as possible in this internet environment, because we've seen all kinds of valuable outcomes when people have the freedom to try things out. So you frequently will hear an open internet, one which is accessible, one which is allows you to try new ideas out without having to get permission from everyone. We use these terms, permissionless innovation. And the network has spawned an enormous amount of utility because people got to try things out. When the World Wide Web was first made most visible in the early 1990s, it was amazing how much information poured into the net because people wanted to share what they knew in the hope that that information would be useful to someone else. They weren't even asking to be compensated for it. What they wanted to know is that something they knew was helpful to someone else. So we have a lot of work to do to allow this kind of open experimentation and exploration for everyone's benefit to continue.